Good morning. This morning we're starting to make our meatballs. I have everything laid out on the paper from the deli. I have 5 pounds of ground chuck. I have about 4 ounces of Parmesan cheese. More like 6 ounces of Parmesan cheese. I have parsley, garlic flakes, garlic powder, salt, pepper, eggs, breadcrumbs, and I do it right here on the paper. I'm going to beat the eggs and put the eggs over here. I'm going to do my breadcrumbs, and then we're going to roll and place on a tray and bake them in the oven at 375. I bake them in a convection oven until they're just about done. I have the sauce on the stove already cooking with the pork. Pork's almost tender. I have my grandson, my little helper. Say hi, Christian.
Hi.
He's going to help roll the meatballs. Of course, his hands are washed and sanitized. We're going to put a little bit of onion in here. I forgot to put the onion, dried onion. So I do like to put that in there for flavor. But this is how the process starts, right here, 5 pounds. We're going to put some dried onions.
Yeah, we're going to do it.
Pretty much the same amount as I would the garlic. You got to have flavorful meatballs. Mm-hmm. Too many people make meatballs with no flavor. Hard as a rock.
When you put that on there, that's... What do you need, Grandma? Grandma.
We have the breadcrumbs. This is not my first choice, but today I'm actually having company and I'm in a little bit of a hurry. These are flavored breadcrumbs by Rulli's. Rulli's is the only local grocer that I use. I love Rulli's. It's an Italian market. They have everything fresh, great prices. I just love shopping at Rulli's. It's my go-to store. I try not to shop anywhere else. I've been satisfied there for over 30-something years now. So as you can see, I try to put the same amount of cheese and breadcrumbs. Maybe a little bit more cheese. Here's the breadcrumbs. Now I'm going to get my egg. Since I have 5 pounds, I will use 3 eggs. If I do 4 pounds or less, I do 2 eggs.
Okay, where's the roller? Whoa, why do you have eggs, Grandma?
Always beat your eggs before you put them on there. I try to beat them very nicely. Okay, all set. Pour your eggs over, sporadically, over your meatball mix. And there we go.
Grandma's going to get out.
Yeah, we're ready to roll. There you go. This is a beauty. These are going to be fantastic meatballs. Roll up the sleeves, and this is where we start mixing. You want to evenly get all of those flavors together. Marry all those flavors together. Too many times people make meatballs, absolutely no flavor. I spread the meat out evenly on the deli paper. I find that that's the best way to evenly distribute all of the spices, the parsley, the garlic, the onion, the eggs, the cheese. Now, my grandson and I just had to run to the store to get cheese. Normally, I have plenty of Parmesan cheese on hand. I refuse to make meatballs without enough Parmesan cheese. Parmesan cheese or Romano or any kind of Italian cheese that you like grated is a secret to good meatballs. If you don't have a nice amount, and I could tell by looking at the meatballs if there's enough at the mix, if there's enough cheese. Now I'm feeling like this isn't enough cheese, So I'm going to add a little bit more. Don't be chintzy on your cheese, or your meatballs are not going to be good.
When you taste your meatballs, just taste it.
Yeah, you want to taste that cheese in the meatballs, and you want to taste that garlic and the spices and the pepper and all of it. If you can't do your meatballs with the cheese, don't make them. Okay, so now I think we have enough cheese on there. Evenly distributed. Somebody told me a long time ago, might have been my grandmother, might have been my mother. I don't know. It was so long ago. I've been doing this for so long. In order to tell if you have a good meatball mix, take a piece of the meat and smell it. You can smell the garlic. You can smell the onions. You can smell all the flavors, the parsley. That's when you know you have a good meatball mix. Then you take it. There's your meatball. Nice size. I'll probably get, by my guesstimation, because I've been doing this for so long, I will say I will get between 40 and 45 meatballs today. We'll see how close I get. Okay. So now we're going to roll.
What's under here?
And then we're going to place on the tray. Have the tray. We're going to place the meatballs on the tray. I do five. Five to start. Then I just line them up. Doesn't matter how close they are together, they're going to cook down a little bit. When you think your meatballs are too big, they're probably not. If you decide to make them a little bit smaller, they're probably going to be too small. So what I try to do is keep uniform consistency on them in size, but believe me when I tell you, none of them are the same. That's Christian over there. Christian, would you like to roll a meatball?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Move your stool over a little bit. I'm going to have Christian roll with me, and just to be sure, we're going to wipe his little hands off first.
Yeah, because I touched the meatballs.
Yep. Okay, let's wipe your hands. Me and Christian are going to make meatballs. Okay. Okay, Christian, you got to roll your sleeves up. Pull them sleeves up. Okay, there you go.
Now let's make a meatball.
Make your meatball. Go ahead. Roll it up. Show them over there how you roll the meatball. Roll it real nice. Yep. Okay. Nice job. Nice job, Christian.
Nice. Cut it.
No, you have to just, see, there's Christian's meatball. We're going to roll it up a little bit more for Christian. Okay, there's five. Okay, we got 10. Let's see how close we get here.
No, let me make another meatball.
Okay, honey, you can do another one. Okay. All right, there's another one. All right. They say you have a passion in life and you know what you want to do. I look at people that love art and writing. My granddaughter, Christian's sister, she loves to write. She's probably going to be a little writer and write books. Marissa, my Marissa, she'll be 9 on Tuesday. But I know my passion is cooking. I get that from way, way back in generations of people in my family that cook, both sides. Both sides, Italian, Nablodon, Sicilian. Grandparents, Italian descent on my father's side. My grandmother, her husband was from Italy. My grandmother was born in Italy, immigrated to the United States. She was the most amazing cook in the world. We have tried to learn from her. I will never probably even be close to what my grandmother cooks, and people think I'm an excellent cook. My grandmother was amazing. Her name was Stefanina. She passed away in 2006 at the age of 88. I miss her. She made the most amazing stuffed artichokes, and her eggplant, no one could make eggplant like my grandmother. Her eggplant was amazing. So we're just still going to roll here. I am going to show you the sauce I have cooking on the stove. while we're rolling. Christian, you keep rolling. Roll a nice meatball, okay? So we have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25 so far. Looks like we may be right on track. I'm going to wash my hands off, show you the sauce, and take a little break.
Here's my meatball. Now, Grandma, now let's do the other one. Now let's do the other part. Okay. Over there.
Okay.